to the mic with the B-boy stance, to the brave hearted MCs, I wouldn't take a chance. Keep quiet while the MC rapping. If you disrespect me, it's the big payback. The E-double-E is my name, I spell. Things to the clientele, my squad rocks well. I'm in your hood coming through like what? Chromed out, beamed out in an all-black truck. You a player? What team you with? I got major chips, I push the flyest whips. Got the flyest chicks, my outfits be freshly dipped. No matter what the steez, I'm equipped.
Well, my name is MD. I'm known as the motivator. Funky beat maker, new Jack Terminator. Joy to destroy
because your rhymes. Why am I not charging everything anymore?
I don't like the indie rock when I'm playing kickball.
Yeah.
It makes me sad.
Just crying on the mound.
I would give a lot to see you cry on the mound.
I can't open this with bare hands, man.
7:30 hour.
Now that I'm not running everything, I can complain about shit.
Yeah.
Play some goddamn pop music, Keith Morehart. Fuck.
Whatever happened to Jason Derulo? That shit really got my juices flowing.
The 5 o'clockers played Peanut Butter Jelly Time on Field 1.
Played none of this acoustic shit.
5 o'clockers earned a 9-1 win, but not before a little drama through the first four innings as they held a 2-1 lead going into the fifth. PBJ was fired up from what I saw, but then 5 o'clockers able to blow it open late.
Yeah, we got that 5-1, so the top...
Yeah!
We got the peanut jellies, dog. I play good.
I do the kickball! I do the kickball good!
These Yinglings are going down good. Oh, I'll tell you about this game. PB&J.
Oh, okay. Is that what we do now, usually?
Very impressive. I tip my cap to them. They came out. They were playing. They got the top of our order. I was kicking fifth. So they allowed one runner in the first, shut us down. They came out and we're like, oh, these dudes are for real. They're ready to play.
Oh, dip.
I had to lead off the second inning. I got on.
As usual.
Had some good aggressive base running.
As usual.
Myself, I scored a run.
As usual.
Courtney Eford, she came up, she scored a run. There's a little bit of.
I'll go with that more than I will.
So we got our two runs.
Uh-huh.
And we thought, all right, now it's time to start rolling and everything. But PB&J, they were locked down. I mean, I was impressed with their charger, James Griffin. He was making some plays. All around their outfield was solid. They played well until the fifth inning. Then the wheels fell off, and we just found that spark that we haven't had. We just started rolling, man. They couldn't get us out. We might have scored like 5 straight runs without an out to start off the fifth inning. And yeah, that's been a problem apparently from talking to some of those guys afterwards at Lucky's. That's been a problem for them all season, is that fifth inning they struggle a little bit, and that's where the defense kind of gets shaky. So I think they only practice 4 innings when they're when they're at practice, they only go four innings.
Yeah.
And that's why they have
trouble. That was a good one, man. That was a legitimate chuckle. Like, I wasn't doing a fake podcast laugh. That was funny.
You fake?
No.
Never.
So, PB&J, I will say this. They're talented. This game was 9-1. It got out of control. Got away from them, but... that does not represent how good a team they are. I think they are a good team. So look for them to do some more damage, I think, as the season goes on. And they could be someone who could potentially hang with the team and get an upset in the first round of the playoffs, depending on what the matchup was.
Upset alert, 1 month early. I like it.
Hey, I'm just saying, that's what I called. No, I'm not calling it. I'm just saying it could happen.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
All right. Yo, Foot Snipers, just saying, hey, remember us?
We're back.
As if we ever left. They win by a touchdown, 7-0 over free ball, and shut it down with the D. And then once again, as we said the last couple weeks, finally getting their offense rolling against what is a quality lineup for free ball. But just from what I saw, They're hitting on all cylinders. Guys, who was playing catcher for them? I can't remember your name, sir, but you're a gentleman, and you were playing.
Matt Kell?
Maybe. I really can't remember his name at all.
Is he sexy?
Yes, thank you. I was confused by your pronunciation of that last name.
It is Cow. That's
yeah.
A, that's
so I'm glad I didn't try and say it, because then I would have sounded like an asshole. like I said.
Cow.
Yeah.
The Snipers kind of like the cool kids to the party, you know. The party started in week one. They're like, man, fuck this. Y'all show up. Do what you gotta do. We'll be there about 30, 45 minutes later. And here they come rolling in.
30, 45 minutes later.
About 3 feet.
3 feet.
Late, showing up, and then it's going to come in, yeah, we're going to last longer than you guys do. So, I mean, look at them to keep this momentum going into the tournament. I know, me too, man.
I'm so impressed by the Foot Snipers' defense over the last four games. They've only allowed one run, so they're shutting people down. You know, Anthony Williams playing charger, Matt Kalp a catcher, McCoy Wood pitching. I'm sure they mixed a couple other guys in there, but they've really been, Jimmy Wilcox charging also. Yeah, they've really been impressive, man. Foot Snipers, they're looking like the team we thought they'd be. So
who was that one? Who scored that one run against Foot Snipers?
That was you guys. Was that you guys or?
Oh,
all
right.
I just want to sneak that in there.
Yeah. All right. Let's talk about Rumspringa finally scoring some more runs.
Yeah.
In the last game of 7:30 hour, an 8-3 win over the new Kickheads. That's got to hurt you personally, R.A., Mr. Welbrock. It's got to...
It does. If,
really bring it down.
If I gave up the majority of the runs...
He's about to throw Rusty on
the no, I'm not throwing
Rusty. That's exactly what I wanted.
No, me and Rusty are a team, man. We don't throw each other under the bus. We're 100%. We got each other's backs. But Ricky came out...
yeah, he was throwing some shit.
But yeah, he wasn't throwing as good as I was.
Is that you doing that while Brock doing Brent?
Yeah.
That was, oh, man. But,
it's like a twins when Schwarzenegger and DeVito are a team.
I guess. Yeah. Well, anyway, so...
he's like that Danny DeVito.
Anyway, let's talk about some kickball. So, new Kickheads came out, and Rick kind of deployed a new tactic that I was kind of looking forward to suggest to him earlier in the season about having like an A squad and a B squad. Remember we were talking about...
Which one are you on?
Eh, don't worry about that.
I'm worried about that.
He's like the microwave off the bench.
Yeah, man, I guess I keep things cooking on the sideline, and when my buzzer dings, I go out there and get the job done. That's not the point. The point is this, is we got the A squad and the B squad is based on chemistry. But remember the America game? Wait, just fucking listen. I'm trying to...
The Alpha Squad and the Beta Squad.
Yeah. Remember when we were like...
I showed the America walk-off today at school. I just wanted to say that. All right. Go on.
Okay, the America walk-off. Let's show that real quick. All right. Yeah. Remember we were saying that, you know, had things been different, how we know the inning would have been called, we would have had this lineup in.
Okay.
All right, so we went with that. So we had the A, B squad. And new Kickheads actually came out and put up two runs in the first inning. They were up to kick first. So Rumspringa coming in here thinking that we're going to get this win and walk all over this team. It started out not happening. But, you know, we didn't cave in or anything like that and say, oh, shit, the sky's falling down. Came out, put on some runs really quickly, got it to be 3-2. Ricky Holmes finally getting back onto the offensive prowess, getting on base, getting those nice bunts in, so good to see him back in action, getting over that little slump. And then, like we were saying, the top of the order got through, and defense, I think we played great. Fran had a fantastic catch in the outfield with some other good spots. Merritts had a nice chug from third to home, sliding in to get that one of the runs in. So good to see him playing, and it was a good game for us after going through that first half of the stretch. So hopefully we got a little bit more confidence now. The monkey off the back, if you will,
get the swag going,
get the swag back, and start taking it to some teams.
Get a little spring on it in your step.
Ooh. Yeah, exactly. But yeah, it was fun. It was fun. I like the way everybody came out. It was a lot of energy. If we just have that energy every week, it would be awesome.
Good stuff, man.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right. That's it for 7:30. We'll be back with the 8:30 recaps real quick-like.